Now let's talk about the lacquer disc production. Hi, this is Takashino from Jazz Blues Japan. Yes, today I just want to talk about the lacquer disc production. You know, before, some time ago, you know, I just talked about the, you know, pressing company here in Japan. There was only one pressing company here in Japan for many, many years until 2018. You know, the company is called Toyokase. Yeah, in Kanagawa Prefecture. Yeah, they have been making very high quality vinyl records, you know, pressing the vinyl records. And the major companies here in Japan, like King Record, Toshiba EMI, Victor Music Japan, Wana Pioneer, they used Toyokase to press their vinyl records, you know, for many years, especially in the 80s up to the 90s, even now. So they are the experts of the experts. I love that company, and also I'm proud to be a Japanese that we have that great company here in Japan. And 2018, another company, you know, Sony Music Japan, you know, started their own pressing facility in Shizuoka Prefecture. And since then, they have been also making a very high quality vinyl records. Yeah, which I also love, you know. I already talked about that, you know, pressing companies here in Japan. But today, I just want to talk about the lacquer production. You know, without a lacquer disc, there'll be no vinyl records. So it's that important, you know. Even if we have the pressing companies, you know, without the lacquer disc, of course, there'll be no production of the vinyl records. So it's that important. And as you know, in the world, there are only two companies making the lacquer discs, really. One is in the U.S., but that company in the U.S., Apollo Trusco, had a problem in 2020, right? You know, their facility was destroyed completely by the fire. And at that time, all the people in the industry were panicked because of that incident, you know. There'll be no lacquer disc. So what are we going to do? But you know, the other company came in. And that the other company is located here in Japan. The company is called Public Record. And Public Record is located in the prefecture called Nagano Prefecture, which happens to be our neighbor. You know, we are in Yamanashi Prefecture, and Nagano Prefecture and Yamanashi Prefecture are the neighbors, you know. We are next to each other. Maybe it takes 1 hour by car to that company. So it's that year. And the Public Record at that time, you know, they worked around the clock to cater for the needs of the lacquer discs all over the world because of that incident at Apollo Trusco. And that's the time many analog vinyl record lovers all over the world came to know that small company, Public Record. Actually, you know, Public Record is a very small company. If you look at the place, you know, Nagano Prefecture, where the company is located, it's very remote. I'm sorry to say, but you know, it's very remote. It's surrounded by the, yeah, the nature. But I just read an article by the president of Public Record. He's very passionate about, you know, making the high quality lacquer discs. He founded that company, Public Record, in 1976, and since then, by the way, you know, the reason why he wanted to start that company making the lacquer disc is because at that time in the 70s, of course, there was no company making the lacquer disc. Yes, the pressing facilities are there, but you know, there is no facility or the company making the lacquer disc. So he wanted to make one, you know, here in Japan. So that's the start of the company, Public Record. So since then, they have been trying, you know, improving the quality and also the volume of the, you know, manufacturing the lacquer discs. And yeah, they were trying, you know, for many years like that. But when it came to the 80s, the late 80s, as you know, that's a trend. The CD era came, and the needs for the lacquer discs went down drastically, really, maybe one tenth of the peak, you know, production era. So Mr. Okuda, the president, really, you know, thought about closing the company. But you know, I respect him very much by him saying in that interview that you know, he really was stressed at that time because of the sales, you know, going down drastically, and nothing to do. But you know, after the conversation with the other core members of the company at that time, he told them, you know, I just want to continue making these, you know, lacquer discs. If there is only one person needing our lacquer disc in the world, I want to make that one disc to him. So I just want to continue with this business. Yeah, that's what he said, something like that, you know, in the conversation. Despite of that hardship, you know, they continued manufacturing the lacquer discs. Of course, they started, you know, they embarked on the other business, like, you know, making the hard disks of the computers or whatever, or the CD, whatever. But, you know, they never stopped manufacturing the lacquer discs. And then the trend came when it comes to the 2000 era. So the demands of the lacquer discs, I mean the vinyl records, you know, came back again. And now, again, the lacquer disc production became their main business, really. So I respect that president of the public record, really, yeah, Mr. Okuda. I respect him very much. And I just put the link of the company, you know, down below here. And they didn't have the English version of the homepage or the website, but nowadays, you know, they made a English version, just one page, but and also the YouTube video. Maybe you can have a look at it. Yeah, you'll sense and feel, you know, how hard they have been doing this business, and also, you know, their quality control and the passion that they put in making the lacquer discs, really. Just go and look at that homepage, really. That's it for today. I hope you like it. I wish maybe I will, you know, have a visit to that company and talk with the president of that company, whom I really respect, really. Okay, lastly, I always keep praying, wishing you guys, family members, co-workers, everybody to be safe in this pandemic situation. Please continue staying safe. And I always appreciate you guys for supporting us, doing business with us. Thank you very much for watching today, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.